Everybody, I am the Mademoiselle and this is my channel. And today we're gonna talk about how black women are sellouts.
I didn't say that shit. They're always saying that shit about us, okay? We have another reaction.
Yo, we're gonna react to a video I believe was actually sent in my Media Hustle chat. You guys are not aware, I have a separate business called Media Hustle where I do consultation for you guys. And essentially, you guys can reach out to me, do a one-on-one consultation, get a strategy, get a mentorship for your Instagram, your TikTok, your YouTube, whatever the case may be, in order to grow online and eventually make social media your side hustle. Everything is gonna be linked down below. We also have a Facebook group where you guys can connect with one another. And I do have a group chat where people just be throwing videos, bouncing off one another. And this video was thrown in the chat and somebody was like, yo, these videos are like really embarrassing. Like, you know, black people are the only type of people that make these types of videos about one another. And sadly, I agree. Like, these videos of black men are horrible. This is what they're doing now. And black women are terrible. How can they do this to us? Like, you know what I'm talking about. The man is fear, the woman's fear, red pill, pink pill, rainbow pill. Like, those videos are just embarrassing. Can we all agree on both ends? Whether we're talking about statistically, morally, they're just really annoying, okay? You don't see white people doing these videos about each other. You don't see Indian people doing these videos about each other. You don't see other races and ethnicities of people making these videos about each other. But for whatever reason, black people, we love making these videos about each other. And I will say, hey, it helps pay my bills. So who am I to complain? Okay, but I will say it is very distasteful that these videos pop up every day and there's people that make like their whole channels dedicated to dragging black men or black women. It is kind of sad. So we're going to react to this video, talk about black women are sellouts. It's going to be interesting. It's about 11 minutes, so get your tea, get your snacks. This is kind of a long one. Hopefully we're not sitting here for too long. I'm going to try not to pause it, but of course you already know the deal. It is going to be linked down below, but just in case I do forget, just type in black women are sellouts. You'll be able to find the video. So let's get into it.
Modern women. Black women in particular.
I'm sorry, but I have to say, what the fuck is up with this Dollar Tree pimp suit? Is he a pimp? Is he a gentleman? As they like to say, he a gentleman? He would be way more appealing if he didn't dress like that. Maybe he's actually important. Maybe he does something important, but the outfit's already a turn off. The cigar's a turn off. This is gonna be hard to watch. I should've grabbed the drink, but I have to teach kids in like 2 hours.
Humble opinion are the biggest sellouts. They have sold out the black American race. I'm talking about the modern day black woman. Now what I'm going to do is give you my definition of what selling out means, and then I'm going to give you 2 examples of my definition, and then I'm going to show you how it applies to the modern day black woman. Here's the exchanging of something valuable to many other people for something that is not valuable to many other people, but is of high value to the person that's sold out. Selling out is the exchanging of something that is valuable to many people for something that is not valuable for many people, but is of high value to the one who sold out. A person can work at the Pentagon in charge of top secret documents, protect us through modern day warfare. That's valuable to many Americans, to many people, but someone may offer that person $100,000 to exchange that.
People be getting on my damn nerves. They be trying to sound way more educated and way more important than they really are without getting to the fucking point. That's what I cannot stand about these men in that specific realm. Get to the fucking point. If what you're saying actually had value, you wouldn't have to speak in metaphors and speak in circles. We know what the fuck a sellout is. We're not dumb. And if we're being real here and we're calling black women sellouts, black men are sellouts too. And I know this is probably, I might not be right. This is probably going to tie into the whole black woman. You know what? Let me not say it because I hope I'm right though. If what I have in my head is right, I'll say it. If not, I'm still gonna say it. But let's just let him say we gotta say because already he's talking in circles.
The other example is this. Jesus Christ is someone who was.
I'm gonna go get a drink. Y'all can watch this.
Everyone on the planet, but Judas sold him out for 30 pieces of silver. That's 30 pieces of silver did not benefit us. It was little value to us, but it was high value to Judas because he got the benefit from the 30 pieces of silver. Now you get what I'm going, right? Now check this out. Black women have sold out their femininity, their submissiveness, their ability to cooperate with men, their ability to be good mothers, and their ability to be good wives. But what was the currency that caused black women to sell out? It was the dreams of being independent, educated.
Wait, I heard that shit. I was getting water, but I heard that shit. First of all, you know, a wise man once told me, men don't match energy. They lead. They elevate. This, sir, is matching energy and trading your masculinity for femininity. This is a bitch move. This is bitch made. This is all exhibiting a lack of fucking common sense and education. Because are you fucking dumb? If you knew anything, you would know exactly why black women act the way they act, as well as why black men act the way they act. And you would also know that this is not one person's fault. I believe everything going on in the black community is a result of both parties being equally negligent, ignorant, and unsympathetic to one another, okay? Both men and women. Why the fuck do you think, okay? Like, literally, this shit gets on my nerves. Why the fuck do you think women aren't feminine anymore? Especially black women. Why do you think so? Do you think black women want to be so hyper independent? Do you think black women want to handle all the bills and literally be the head of the household, the pillars of the black community, do everything by themselves? We don't want to, but we have to. Many women, many children in general, many people in the black community have not grown up with fathers in the home. A lot of us, sadly, not me though, I had a dad. I had many father figures. I love my man. I have many friends, many mentors that were men, but many other women did not. They were not as fortunate as me, right? But many women are forced to have to do what men have not done. I don't know how hard it is for you guys to understand that. And for you men that do stand up, that do what you're supposed to, kudos to you. But there's too many of you guys that sit there and you let your friends, your uncles, your brothers, and all the other men around you be basura. Y'all let all these other men around you not take care of the responsibility. And then y'all sit there, y'all turn around and be like, oh, these black modern women, oh, these modern women, oh, these women, this, that, and the third. No, bitch, you're part of the problem. If you sit here, you see your friends being trash. If you sit here and you see people in your circle or people that you know being trash men and you're not calling them out on it, you're part of the problem because you're helping them continue that cycle, even if it's not you personally doing this, okay? And I know, yes, some women may be hard to deal with. I know some women will probably bar you from seeing your child if you do not cooperate in a way that, you know, they want you to. I understand that, but that should not stop you from being responsible for your child. That should not bar you from doing what you need to do as a man. And that's the vicious cycle that we keep going through. Oh, well, women want to do everything themselves. They want to be independent. They're trading femininity. They have no fucking choice. What the hell do you want them to do? Still be all, why y'all not there? It just doesn't make sense. Like, child.
In a high earning career. So black women have sold us out, the black American race, the black community, because they wanted to be educated, independent, and have a good, strong, high earning career. Never in the history of men, anywhere of any race, have we ever chose a woman based on her independence, her career, or her education.
This is the thing. I'm really fucking sick and tired of you men. Y'all will sit here, leave a woman high and dry because you don't want to be with her because she a jump off, she a thought because she got pregnant by you, okay? I just reacted to a whole video about this. Amanda had 7 kids by 7 women. He was almost like, oh, well, she a jump off. Well, all of them were hoes. So, you know, I don't feel like I have to have responsibility for these kids because I got her pregnant. I told her to get rid of them. Da, 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 da. He said this for all 7 women, apparently. Okay. That's some disgusting shit. But a lot of you guys have this general consensus of, well, you know, women, they want to trade having a career instead of building a family and continuing the black race and da, 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 da. Now, I will say I'm Haitian American, right? However, I was raised in America. I don't see myself different from American people in terms of being seen as a black American person. You're not going to disrespect any black woman in this regard, because what you're not going to do is sit here and be like, oh, well, they have to be broke waiting for y'all dumbasses. Okay? Women have to do what the woman got to do. If a job, if an educational opportunity arises, a woman is gonna take that, especially if they have kids to take care of, if they have family they have to take care of, they have bills to take care of. Y'all not gonna do it. That's the fact of the matter here. You guys aren't going to do it. You guys have consistently not done it. The problem here is women as a whole, not even just black women, women don't feel supported by y'all. That's what it is. We don't feel supported, okay? A lot of women don't feel supported. Until you guys can show that you guys will be there and you guys will do something, it's gonna continue to be like this. I don't know why the hell you guys always bring this argument of, oh, well, you know, you guys traded a career and you guys traded femininity da 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 for money. And it's like, no, that's not what it is. We had to do what we had to do, and we did that shit for the children, for humanity, okay, for our own sanity. We do what we have to do because it needs to get done. We're not gonna sit there and be a broke bitch like a damsel in distress, because eventually a man will come and save us. Eventually a man will come and pay the bills and save the day and provide us with a house. That just doesn't make any logical sense. Like, I would love to know, what do you expect women to do? Like, I genuinely want to know, like, in this logic, what do you expect them to do? Now, I will say I agree. Men really do not choose women based off of how much money they make and the education that they have, because I made this mistake. Like, I used to think, oh, if I have an education and I have a good job, like, I'm just gonna make a man's life easier. Like, I never knew. Like, it was, you know, not counterintuitive. Like, I was young. I was, like, really young. Like, what, 19, 20, whatever. But at the end of the day, that don't mean that I'm not about to be my best self because I want to secure a man. And y'all need to get over that shit. Because of your fragile masculinity, that means I shouldn't go out and be the best me because you're insecure and you think I might make more money than you. Because you think that I might get more educated than you, I shouldn't go out and be the best me. No, bitch. You go out and do the best shit that you can do so you can match my energy. Better yet, so you can lead like you want to. That's the problem. Y'all motherfuckers can't lead, okay? Y'all want to match energy making bitch-ass videos like this, being bitch-made. Like, child.
But that's one of the many ways that black women have sold out the black American race, and I have many others. Also, black women have sold out their self-respect, their chastity, and their honor. What was the currency that was used for them to sell that out? The currency was more views, more likes, retweets, posts, and shares. If you go to OnlyFans, you'll see a lot of women on there selling out their dignity, selling out what's pure, selling out their virtue.
I'll give him that. Absolutely correct. I don't agree with that shit. I know everybody want to be all sex positive and all that, but I'm like, no, you're a bunch of whores. I don't give a fuck. Yes, sex work is work, and I do respect it in a way, but there comes to a point where it's like, you're literally just putting your ass on the internet free. You're not even getting paid for it. And if you are getting paid for it, you're not even getting paid enough to sell your soul. I just feel like everyone should respect themselves if they have a choice. Some of y'all literally have way more than enough choices and you choose to sell ass. I don't think that's okay. But I agree with him with that.
A get rich quick type of scheme.
I give him that.
The black American woman, to me, is on the top of the list selling out.
However, I will say that's not just black women. That's most women. I don't know the statistics for that though. Like, I don't know the statistics of women in sex work, but I will say it's not just black women that do that. So I don't know why we're putting that on us, but hey.
Another thing that they have sold out in the black community, I'm talking about the black modern day woman. They have sold out the black children's health. What do I mean? They have sold it out for this type of currency. Reluctance to cook and laziness and convenience.
Going back to the last point, I feel like if we're gonna talk about the whole situation of women going into sex work, I feel like, yes, there's a lot of women that just do it for a quick buck and they're being lazy as hell and they know damn well they could do 10 times other things, but they just choose to do sex work, and I think that is an issue. However, if you're doing it out of necessity, I feel like that goes back to my first points that I made in this video. A lot of y'all leave these women high and dry with children. You guys leave these women with responsibilities that they cannot take care of by themselves, and now you guys are complaining that they're doing what they need to do to take care of these kids. Yeah, maybe sex work is not the most honorable work you can do, but sometimes that is the only thing a lot of women can do, especially if they're really young, they have no resources, or they're in a specific type of area where, I mean, that's just the easiest thing you can do at the time. So you have to be very sympathetic to things like that, because sometimes some people really don't have a choice. It's rare that that's the only choice that certain people have, but sometimes that's the only thing certain people know to do at the time. Now, when it comes to the health thing, I was about to say I never met a black woman that can't cook, but that's a fucking lie. I have. The whole thing, people that can't cook just makes no sense, but I don't think that's a woman thing. Men that can't cook annoy me too. You can't not know how to cook as a fucking adult. My man is like a Chef Boyardee. Okay, no, Chef Boyardee is not that great, but you know what I mean. Like, my man be chefing it the fuck up. Baking, cooking, frying, all that. Like, my man could cook a really, really good meal. I'm talking about seafood boils, pasta, rice, chicken, steak, all that. Okay, so I need to understand why the hell you guys want to sit here bitch crying, complain about women not being able to cook when you should be able to cook as an adult. That's an adult skill, not a woman skill. That is an adult skill. And if you guys were taking care of your kids as much as women take care of their kids, or as much as we've been trying our best to take care of your kids, when a lot of you guys are at
absent, this wouldn't be a fucking discussion. Because what do you cook, sir? What do you cook? Ramen fucking noodles that you get at the Dollar Tree that you got the fucking suit from? It doesn't make sense. That needs to be something that everybody needs to know how to do. You shouldn't be relying on a woman to cook for your kids. You should be able to cook for your kids too. You shouldn't be relying on a woman to do all of these things. The modern woman is doing any and everything. And you need to learn how to take care of yourself and your kids as well.
American woman, the modernized black American woman do not know how or want to know how, majority of the times, how to cook meals for their children. So what they do, they go to Burger King, McDonald's, Taco Bell, and get all these different poisonous fast foods that's bad for their children's health and feed that to them because they're too lazy to cook, don't want to know how to cook, and they don't like cooking. So they rather jeopardize their children's health. And here it is, we have some of the highest, we are the highest rate in obesity. And the children that we see that are black, they're some of the biggest children you see on the planet in America, and they want to keep feeding them this garbage.
Says the one smoking a cigar. Says the one that don't even look that damn skinny talking all of that shit. All right, this shit is... Wow. It's the audacity for me. Can we just... Oh my god, let me just say, like, on some real shit, most kids eat fast food because they want it. They see it on TV, they're like, mommy, daddy, get me the fast food. Now I will say, if you're literally buying fast food for your kids, breakfast, lunch, and dinner, that's a problem. Okay, fast food maybe once a month, not a bad thing, but you cannot be out here feeding your kid fucking Chicken Shack from the womb. That's a problem. I will say there are parents that do that. I've witnessed it, and that's not a good thing. That's actually pretty disturbing. Like, you should not be out here feeding your kids fast food on a consistent basis, but once in a while is okay. Kids like fast food. Some kids will not eat anything but a damn chicken nugget. Okay, if you have kids, you know that. Okay, I don't even have kids and I know that. Like, some kids, they really enjoy fast food, and sometimes you have to maneuver and cook certain things for them that mimic fast food so that they'll eat it, right? So it's just, it's interesting that he's like throwing that out there, because it's just like, you're smoking a cigar and you don't look that skinny yourself. I'm just saying.
Another thing that the black woman has sold out, she has sold out the black man's peace at home. And the currency for that was, they want to be independent. The currency, the thing that they took that is high valuable, that's highly valuable to them but not valuable to us, is that they like the fact that they can tell a man off, that they can show up a man, that they can cuss a man out, disrespect a man, they're not thankful anymore. This is the type of currency that the modern day black woman has accepted to sell out the black American race.
But what do you do? That's what I need to know. But what do you do? Like I said, I am Haitian American, right? So I know for a lot of people this conversation is completely different for me, but since I was raised in America, this is still up my alley. Dated a good few African American men, okay, black American men, Hispanic men, Haitian men, and it's sad because it's not that far off. Like, it's very crazy because these conversations go on in all of that small bit of diaspora. It's sad to say, a lot of these men are becoming fucking lazy as hell. And I will say, maybe it is because we are becoming so independent. We want to do things by ourselves. And, you know, we're so independent, we don't need a man. So it's like, okay, the man feels like he has nothing to provide for. Understood. But at the same time, if you are proving yourself useless, you don't fucking need to be there. Okay, that's point blank period. If we feel like we're doing everything for ourselves, we're not going to act like you're a valuable asset. You need to prove yourself valuable to be treated valuable. I'm not saying it's okay to be out here cursing out your boyfriend or your girlfriend because, you know, you think they don't do nothing for you. But what's going on here is a lot of y'all men, y'all don't go to school, y'all barely work. If y'all do work, the woman is making more than you. And then y'all sitting here, y'all want to be alphas when in actuality you're beta. That's what it is. You want to tell a woman what to do, you want to control what she wears, you want to control where she goes, you want to control who she's friends with, when you can't do that because you don't control anything. You don't warrant any type of governance when the only thing you have is a penis. The only thing you have is, I'm a man. Like, that's it. And it's like, okay, but what do you do for that woman as a man? Like, you're literally bitch made. Like, at this point, you're bitch made because this video right here is bitch made. Okay, you don't, like, you're not superior in funds. You're not superior in education. You're not superior in the way you act. What do you have? Now, I will say, in Haitian American culture, for the most part, this rarely ever happens. It doesn't matter who makes the money. The man is always going to be the head of the household in terms of making decisions. It's rare, though, that usually it's the
the woman, but most of the times it's always going to be the man. Like, even in my household, like, I've talked about this numerous times on my personal channel. That's where I talk about the personal things. But my mom has always been the breadwinner, but my dad has always, like, ran the household. So it's like, in Caribbean households or in foreign households, it don't matter who make more money, the man is always going to be ahead. But that has a lot to do with cultural differences. So can one say that maybe in Black American culture there's something going on with, you know, the way that they respect one another and it shouldn't matter? Black American culture was never set up to be that way, and it's one of those things where Black American women have been consistently left alone, and Black men, okay, Black American men, you guys are assholes, okay? You guys have not been nice to your woman, okay? You guys don't have a history of being nice to your woman. I'm just gonna say that right now. Like, you guys historically don't have the respect or the trust of your woman. So this is where you guys have that disconnect. That's exactly what the fuck is going on. I don't know why the fuck you guys think that making these videos is gonna change anything. It's just gonna prompt a bunch of stats that are true. It's gonna prompt a lot of pushback, which is warranted. And it's gonna prompt a lot of dragging, which is also warranted.
Another way they have sold out the Black community. I'm talking about the Black American woman. Make no mistake about that. Today's modern Black woman has sold out the traditional Black family structure. Black women are having so many children out of wedlock. They have put the carriage before the horse. They don't wait for marriage. They don't wait for a husband. All they do is lay down with Pookie, Ray Ray, John John, spit out about 2 or 3 kids, and then try to raise the family, try to be both mom and father, and then blame the men for the reason why there's no father in the house. All you simply have to do is sew your legs shut, because the thing is, a lot of you women are just too hot in the butt. And that's the reason why you have so many children running around. Now we gotta worry about these children reaching puberty, becoming teenagers, and hope they don't break into our cars and steal our systems, because you refuse to close your legs and let a good, decent man come into your life and marry him before you decide to give birth to children.
It's the audacity. Y'all not out here fucking Keisha, Ashley, and Alexis, though? Y'all not out here doing that without marriage? You have to be kidding me. Yo, it is the hypocrisy for me with these men. This is out of control. I'm not gonna have any brain cells left by the end of this year, because you're such a Yo, I will say, before we even get to the end, I did think this was gonna be one of those things where it was like, oh, Black women are sellouts because they're marrying white men. I would have been like, no, bitch, y'all be marrying white women, da da da. But okay, it looks like that's not gonna come up. I hope it doesn't come up. I hope it doesn't come up, because then I'm gonna be like, oh man, this man disappointed me. But y'all, did he really? Yo, men, especially Black men, y'all stick y'all dick in anything with a wig on. So I don't even wanna fucking hear it. Like, boy.
There used to be a time when it was shameful to have children out of wedlock, but the Black American woman has sold out so much that her conscience is hardened. Her conscience has been seared. She doesn't feel anything. She thinks everything that she do or doing is okay, and we should accept it. I disagree.
That cigar is getting on my fucking nerves.
But the Black woman today has sold us out in so many ways. The Black American woman has sold out our image and Black men, because they are the ones now telling people that all men are dogs, we're not good for anything except paying the rent.
I'm sorry, y'all could barely even pay the rent if we're being real here, from what I understand, but
rising up and talking back, because we're tired of hearing this for the last 50 plus years about how we don't mean anything to anybody on the planet. We're tired of this. It used to be that they would say that Uncle Tom was a sellout. Not anymore. The Uncle Tom are the Black women. The Uncle Tom is your Janae, your Keisha, your Mika's, your Tiffany's. That's your Uncle Tom's now, because they're the ones selling us out. They used to say that coon. They used to call Black folks coon and say that they were sellouts, Uncle Tom's. The Black American women that are modernized, they're the coons now. They're the ones who turned their back on the race. It's not us. And if the Black women want to try to fix things, then fix them.
I will say straight up, modern men are doing the same thing modern women are doing, especially in the Black community, and it's fucking annoying. Like, these channels, like, so fucking infuriating. Like, these conversations, like, are they not exhausting for you guys? Like, do you not feel some type of way when you post these videos? Like, because I have so many of them sitting in my requests. There's a reason I do them like maybe once every 2 months, because it's just peddling this type of information, talking about this type of behavior is exhausting, okay? Like, it just truly is. And it's sad, okay, to see people talk about each other like this, especially in the Black community, where we're talking about the Black American community community or any other black community. It's just unnecessary as fuck. They're just as bad, if we want to be real here. Okay, the black modern man is just as bad as the black modern woman, because you guys started these damn channels making the dialogue worse, if you want to be real here.
I'm just putting up a mirror in front of your face and showing you what you have done, instead of listening to all your crybaby and stuff talking about, yeah, you did this. Now, ladies, you did this, and this is the reason why we're not getting along, because you are stubborn, and you are entitled, and you are rude, and you are insulting, and you are disrespectful, self-centered, and arrogant, and selfish, and you don't want to listen, which makes you hard-headed, rebellious, and stubborn. And if you would want to listen to the black men, we could have black families again. You have sold out the black families because you have put yourself first, you have put your education first, you put your careers first. Now, not every black woman has a career. Majority of them have just regular jobs, but you have put those things before marriage, before learning how to interact properly with a black man.
Why though? Think about why. A lot of them didn't have fathers, a lot of them didn't have male figures that were important to them or that they can trust. So what makes you think that they're going to trust you, especially when you guys go around talking to them like this? You guys trying to talk to them like you're their fathers and they don't even fucking know you. And then on top of that, you're demeaning to them, you're belittling them, you're not even trying to understand where they're coming from. First of all, I'm not gonna say a lot of black women do make videos like this, but it's not even like this, okay? Like, I will say black women's videos, and don't even say I'm being biased, because you guys can go and look at them, they're not even this type of disrespectful. Like, I find this extremely disrespectful. I feel like they're educational based videos. A lot of them have statistics. I ain't gonna lie, some of them are really disrespectful, but a lot of the main ones, they're research based. They're, you know, you can't really refute the facts, right? But this right here is belittling. You know, it's giving, oh, well, y'all need to listen. Da, da, da. Like, bitch, you're not my dad. Probably why I love my man so much, because he never tried to talk to me like he my fucking father. Okay? Any man that tried to talk to any woman like they are their father, it's never gonna work out. Okay? You guys need to come from a place of understanding and empathy, because if not, it's not gonna fucking work. You want women to treat you like they are your mother, you need to treat that woman with empathy. We don't want to be treated like that. Okay? We don't want another dad. We don't want the dad that we never had. We want empathy, understanding. We want a conversation. Okay? You can't just be coming, oh, black modern woman, she got an education. Oh, that means I gotta treat her like this. Not every woman with an education, not every woman with a career, not every woman that is a modern woman acts the way that you're acting. And I feel like that's another issue. A lot of you guys see a woman that's doing well for herself and you automatically think that she acts the way that this man is acting or saying that we act, and that's not true at all. Like, this portrayal is not true, and that's another issue. I feel like a lot of women, like, y'all be out here attacking these men just like, oh, you're just like the rest, oh, you nigger, like, you're just like the rest of these niggas. No, okay, stop treating people based off the men or the woman that hurt you, because it's never going to be good. And this man, like, first of all, where's your wife at, since you know it all? Like, because all y'all people on these channels, where's your woman, where's your man, where's your wife, where's your husband? You should have multiple. You should be poly at this point, since you know it all. You should have multiple men and women, since you treat everybody so fucking great. Like, it's just, it's infuriating. Like, it truly is.
Until you fix that, nothing can be fixed.
Nigga, you fix it.
You need therapy, and a lot of you need therapy.
You need therapy.
Therapy and a femininity coach. Because therapy ought to show you how to fix what's messed up, what got you reacting the way you react and thinking the way you think. But a lot of women don't know how to sit down with a dress on to keep the legs still wide open when they sit down. They don't know how to wear heels, pumps, or anything like that. Most black women just know how to wear tennis shoes.
I'm dead.
Yeah. So there's nothing feminine about you. You're not ladylike.
Oh,
so this is how you have sold out black America, ladies. So a lot of you women that get in my comment, some of y'all, I made a video about herpes or something like that, and some of y'all getting there, women talking about, yeah, say about the black man dating the black man. Look, let me tell you something. You ain't gotta be on my channel. Go to one of them other channels where men tell you everything is okay, and like, they lie to you, and there's no change. It's the same results. You get the same result, the same outcome. Nothing's changed because they kissing your butt to try to get views and try to get money from it.
Anyways, let me say straight up, I don't even know what the fuck a femininity coach is, but I will say I wear heels every day. I've been wearing heels every day since high school, for real. Like, I love me some heels. I only started wearing sneakers because now I'm a dance teacher and I have to wear sneakers, and even that sometimes I wear heels. Okay, wearing heels is not necessarily a feminine trait. It's just so funny, men are so dumb. Like, y'all think because y'all see a girl in heels that she's automatically feminine. You guys are so dumb. Funny, in high school I used to wear heels every day and I still was fighting in heels.
Like, it don't make sense. Like, y'all really are so fucking dumb. Y'all think y'all know it all. You guys think you're so educated and you guys know absolutely nothing at all. Okay, I was still out here pulling men, grown men, which is nasty. I'm like, y'all are nasty as hell trying to talk to a child. But even at that, even to my adulthood, like, I'm one of the most, like, I was very, like, tomboyish, but I would still have heels on. But then, like, I was still fighting, but then I had my, like, really, really feminine stage, I guess they call it. But then I had my masculine stage, again, all in heels. So it's like, don't be thinking just because a girl has heels on, she's feminine. Yeah, I know how to sit in a dress. I know how to be girly, but it's just like, that's not what femininity is. Like, okay, you guys are just, men are so fucking, don't let a man tell you what the fuck femininity is. Just don't, okay? I will say he's right though. There is something wrong with the disconnect between the black community, men and women and all of that. But a man ain't gonna fucking fix it in terms of what's wrong with women. But then again, a lot of these fucking situations that I see these women putting out is just as bad. So at this point, we just need God. We need to pray. We need to pray. Yep, prayer is what we need because Jesus Christ.
I care about you. I don't
know
you tell
don't.
The truth.
I don't think
so. All right, so you go over there. If you don't like, go someplace else. Don't tell me what men are doing. This is a men's channel. Go to your little, but if you got a channel where you do a video in the bathroom or wherever you do it at outside on the tree, I don't know whether you go over there and put that on your sorry little channel and leave us real men alone. Now, real women, you are welcome to be on this channel if you're going to help solve the problem that we are having in Black America. If you're willing to be feminine, if you're willing to be submissive, and if you're willing to listen, so there can be a change, you're more than welcome to be on this channel. You're more than welcome to comment and whatever. Ooh. I don't care. But all you hard-headed heifers out there who don't want there to be a change, that you keep single women single, take your butt someplace else with that trash, man. Cause ain't no butt. I'm not responding to you. And men, you have all my permission to take them out the game. You go ahead and talk to them. You know what I mean? Cause my time is valuable. I'm trying to do something for the black community here. I'm trying to point out some flaws. I ain't got time to be going back and forth with some of you weak persons out there. Again, thank y'all for your time. Have a good one.
That was the most disturbing hard-headed heifers. I'm using that. I like it. Hard-headed helpless. You guys hear me saying that? I got it from Mr. Jeremy Hill because that was actually pretty funny. I will say some of the points he made were valid. I'm not gonna lie. But the thing is, y'all need to be sympathetic. Where do you think these issues come from? Where did they arise from? Where did they occur? Where did they start? That's the thing that you guys are not understanding. These things started, these things occurred, these things came from a multitude of different issues that started from men. Men leaving the homes, fathers not being fathers, whatever the case may be, you know. And some of these could date back to slavery, to white men, whatever, generational trauma. Like, there's a lot of things that go into this. I don't like how everything is a black woman's fault, and that's not even just because I'm a black woman, it's because it's not inherently true, you know. Like, when you really look into things and you really just like sit and try to understand what things are and how things work, you realize, like, okay, you know, maybe that's not why things are the way they are. Maybe this is not why men are the way they are, women are the way they are. Maybe we can try to think of better ways to solve this, but bashing each other is not the way. These videos be stressed to be out. Like, I just be sitting there like, another one. Sage, I'm filming. Go to sleep. Like, it's just so sad. Like, do we have to do this? Like, do we really have to do this? Like, do we have to do this all the time? Like, it's crazy because I thought these types of videos would die. I thought these channels would die. But it's like every day there's a new one. And it's like, do we have to make entire brands off of dragging the communities in which we are part of? What in the? You want to lay like a baby? Okay, here you go. She likes to be coddled like this, guys. It's ridiculous. Do we have to have, like, these channels where we drag each other for filth and tell everyone what's wrong with ourselves? Again, you don't see other races and ethnicities of people doing this. You only see black people doing this, okay? Like, it's just unfortunate, okay? With that being said, let me know what you guys think about this video down below. Do you think that he made valid points? Because to be honest, I do. I just feel like they were kind of lacking the reasoning behind them. It's just the, oh, well, black women are doing this, but it's like, okay, but there's a reason why they're doing this, you know? And it's the same thing on the other side. Like, black women will make these videos and I'm like, well, there's a reason black and do this, you know. It's just, it's always going to be a constant pointing finger continuous battle. With that being said, I have to take care of Sage because she thinks she's a baby. Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that, and I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye. I'm gonna put you down now.